guys, thanks for watching. Welcome to my channel, Soumya's Book Station. I am Soumya. If you like my videos, please like and share them and subscribe to my channel. And please do not forget to press the bell icon so that every time I post a video, you get notified. So I am back with a video in which I spread more book love by talking about 10 books that made my 2017 so much better. In case you want to know which all books I read in 2017, I'll leave the link to that video in the description box. Let me tell you about the 10 books that became my top favorite out of all the books that I read in 2017. Also, I reviewed some of these books either on my blog or my channel or maybe both. I'll leave the link to those reviews in the description box. First book is Remnants of a Separation by Achal Malhotra. So this book is non-fiction and it contains the accounts of 19 people who have shared their experiences from the time of partition of India. People who came from Pakistan to India, people who went from India to Pakistan, even a family that came from Bangladesh to India, and also an Englishman. So there is such a wide variety that you get to read in this book. Also, this book is so very riveting. Stories and experiences shared by people in this book seem to be so otherworldly and so surreal even that for a moment you start doubting if it is fiction or non-fiction. But of course, those stories are real, which makes the book even more incredible and astounding. This is a magnificent book. I would not shy away from calling this book a masterpiece. The next book is Lincoln in the Bardo by George Saunders. This book also won the 2017 Man Booker Prize. This book is an amalgamation of reality and fiction. The reality is that Abraham Lincoln's son, Billy Lincoln, died at the age of 11, which left his father really shattered. In this reality, the author has woven a beautiful story that majorly takes place in a state called Bardo, which according to Tibetan tradition is a state between life and death, kind of an intermediary state. After his death, Billy Lincoln wakes up in the state called the Bardo, where he sees a lot of other spirits, a lot of other dead people who are clamoring, making noises. This is an absolutely beautiful story and I feel the concept is so unique. This book really shook me because of the way everything has been handled in this book, from the general sense of loss of a loved one to the realization that everything and everyone in this world is here for a temporary time, even if it means one's own children. The author did a splendid job with this book. This book is, according to me, a well-deserved winner of the 2017 Man Booker Prize. Although, to be fair, I did not read all the 6 books that were shortlisted. I read 4 out of the 6 that were shortlisted. Still, this was my favorite out of the 4. Next book is Hercule Poirot's Christmas by Agatha Christie. Now, I've read quite a few Agatha Christie books in 2017 and this was definitely one of the really good books that I read by her. Everything about this book is so amazing. I enjoyed reading it so much. The murder mystery is amazing. The way the story pans out, the way the suspense unfolds, it was a complete delight to read it. I wasn't able to guess what was going to happen, and also I really loved the conclusion of the story, so as I said, I was happy on every count. And I've already sung so many praises of this book, so let me just tell you a little bit about the story. So a murder takes place in a very wealthy household in London where everyone is under the suspicion. Now Hercule Poirot has to solve this murder. The next book is Flame in the Mist by Renée Edyard. Even though this is not a standalone book, it's the first book in a duology, I still love this book a lot. I'm eagerly waiting for the second book to come. So this is the story of a 17-year-old Mariko, and the story is set in feudal Japan. Mariko is being sent to the city of Inako by her parents. She is going there with a group to get married to a man she hasn't even met. On the way, her group gets attacked and everybody dies except her, so she decides to avenge everybody's death and she dresses up as a boy and infiltrates the group called the Black Clan, who killed everybody in her group. But there she's appreciated also. She starts to fall in love, so it becomes really complicated. I had a very good experience reading this book because it had everything to make me happy. It had suspense, it had snatches of romance. Next book is Home Fire by Kamila Shamsi. So this book is a story of 4 British Muslims, Isma, Parvez, Anika and Iman. Now Isma, Parvez and Anika are 3 siblings and Isma is the eldest sibling. All her life she took care of her younger siblings like their mother, but now that they've grown up, Isma can pursue her education that she always wanted to. She can basically live her own life, so she leaves for the United States. Isma is a very level-headed and a practical kind of a person. Anika is very beautiful and very confident. Too confident for her own good is what Isma feels. Parvez, on the other hand, has decided to follow the steps of his jihadi father. There is the character of Iman, who comes into the lives of both Isma and Anika at different points of time. Iman is the son of a British Muslim politician, and Iman is somebody who is very handsome and charming. This is such a story that it sucks you right in. The story was very gripping, it was engaging. Even if it was a sad story, but it was sad in a way that just did not let me put the book down. This book has actually covered a wide area of topics. One of them is terrorism, the other is familial bonding, the lifestyle of immigrants in the UK, more specifically British Muslims and how their lives are generally. Even though this book is fiction, I feel it is heavily inspired from real life. Next Next book is Ghajar Gojar by Vivek Chanbhag, translated by Srinath Perur. This is a story of a family that goes on to become a wealthy family from being a low-income family. It's kind of a rags-to-riches kind of a case where they start a business and it turns out to be very good, and that contributes to their social standing. The story has been narrated by one of the family members. He is a very keen observer, and the main theme of the story is that even though the financial standing of the family changes, their internal dynamics do not change at all. They remain fiercely loyal to each other, support each other even when one of the family members does something wrong. I think this book is very relatable at some point or the other for every reader because of the way it has been penned down. It doesn't matter if your financial standing changes, you never really forget your roots. That is something that this book has really highlighted. It has been done very well, very effectively, and the message that the author intended to convey through this book has been conveyed pretty well. The next book is Persepolis by Martin Satrapi. So this is a graphic novel. In this book, Martin Satrapi has talked about her life in 1980s and 1990s Iran, and she has talked about how things in Iran got more and more regressive as time passed, and how it was for them as citizens to live in a country like that under such an oppressive regime. And Martin Satrapi has told her story in the most amusing manner, even though it's a very serious story. Living in a country where people were not free, freedom of expression wasn't there, and people had to follow a code of conduct while living their lives, it was a very controlled kind of an existence. She has told her story with so much raw humor that makes this novel even more edgy, and it's also poked fun at the oppressive regime of Iran. Don't get me wrong, I have read some really good graphic novels, but none of them have come close to Persepolis. The next book is Baaz by Anila Chauhan. So this story is set in 1970s when war broke out between Pakistan and Bangladesh, and India got embroiled in that war. In the midst of all this, we get to read the story of Ishan Fauzdar, who is referred to as Shanu fondly by everybody. Also, he has a well-earned name called Baaz. And we also get to read about Tehmina Dadiseth or Tinka. Tinka is a talented and a charming girl. Ishan is an Indian Air Force officer, but somebody that everybody easily likes. Ishan and Tehmina get attracted to each other, and things become somewhat complicated because Ishan, being an Air Force officer, feels that it's his duty to be a part of the war, to protect his country, to bring glory to his motherland. Tehmina is somebody who really espouses peace, and she is somebody who thinks that war solves nothing. This is a book that celebrates almost every emotion after the years, the romance, the friendship, and this book is entertaining to say the least. The story in this book turns out beautifully, even if it's heartbreaking. The next book is How to Be a Boss by Lily Singh. This book did not disappoint me in the least. This is one amazing self-help book. This book is divided into four sections: Master Your Mind, Hustle Harder, Make Heads Turn, and Be a Unicorn. You finish this book feeling really happy and really pumped up and charged because Lily Singh has talked about what she thinks should do to achieve success, and she has infused this book with her positivity, which makes this book an even better read. Towards the end of each of these four sections, there is an out of the blue section where she has talked about her own personal experiences. That definitely adds to the appeal of the book. At the end of the day, no matter how much a person or a book motivates you, it's you who has to go out and do what is to be done. But this book does a pretty good job of motivating you. Next book is Homegoing by Yagyasi. So this is the story of two half sisters, Effia and Essie. They never really get to meet each other. Their destinies are also pretty different. Effia gets married to an English slaver, and Essie, on the other hand, gets sold into slavery. This difference in their destinies also leads to the differences in the lives of their respective families. Now, this is a book that spans many generations, and it also spans three continents. The main theme of this book is the effects, or as you can say, ill effects of racism that really seep down the generations. I really liked how the story culminated. The end really worked for me. Even though the story in this book is very sad, I never really wanted to put it down. And the story really left its mark on me, and I wasn't able to forget the story long after I finished reading it. And if that's not the sign of a good book, I don't know what else is. So these are the 10 books that became my favorite in 2017 out of all the books that I read. This is not to say that I did not read other good books, but at the same time, these books had something or the other that made them stand apart for me. Do not forget to share your own list of favorites of 2017. I would love to hear from you guys. So that's it for today's video, guys. If you want to connect with me on my social media, then the links are in the description box. I'll be back with my next video super soon. Bye!